Good morning students, welcome back to the English Channel Prime. Students, today we'll learn a new lesson, that is poem 2, that is Great Grandmother for grade 5. Children, who is a great grandmother? Do you know? Yes, great grandmother meaning the mother of our grandparents. That is our parents, then their parents are called the grandparents, and then their grandparents are called the great grandparents. And if it is a mother, then great grandmother. Let's start with the pre-reading activity. Find a photograph of your great grandparents. Write a description of the same. Children, do you have any photograph of your great grandparents? Do you have? Can you explain them? Can you describe their look? Let me describe my grandparents' look. My grandmother is very good to look. She was tall and white to look, healthy to look. And she used to be my role model. Why, you know, children? Because I used to admire her. Because of her strong will and loyalty and caring nature. She used to take care of us very well. And for many years when she was old, she used to leave herself independently. She could take care of herself. So because of that, she is my role model. Similarly, why do you think knowing about our grandparents and great grandparents is necessary? Do you think knowing about them is necessary? Yes. Yes, you miss them a lot. Okay. So children, why you need to know about them? Because they have a lot of wisdom. Because they have a lot of experience of generations. So if there is any trouble, any unknown thing happening, then they would have a great solution to that because of their experiences in life. So we need to know about our grandparents. Third, have you looked at old photographs and have remembered people? Have you begun speaking to your family members about them? Yes, children, whenever we go through the old photographs, we used to see a lot of relatives, cousins, brothers, sisters, and parents, grandparents, isn't it? And we used to ask them, who are they? And we used to know about them. They would be holding us when we are very small. We would not be recognized them in after 10 or 15 years. So we used to ask them about by seeing the old photograph. So now let's start this poem, Great Grandmother. It is written by Alan Malley. Alan Malley, let's know about the poet first. He is a professor associated with ELT, that is English Language Teaching, and he is associated with this institute for over 50 years. He was born on January 1931, and he is a very creative person, and he worked for the British Council in many countries like Yugoslavia, Ghana, Italy, France, China, India, in many countries. And he was the director of BET in Cambridge. Now let's start the poem. First I will read it, then I will start explaining one after one paragraph. Let's start. Listen carefully. She looks out at me from the yellowing photograph, misted over by time. It is a frank and serious look. Her eyes are stern, but they can laugh too. So children, she looks out at me, meaning, is she really looking from the photograph? No, the poet feels that his grandmother is looking out. That means she is searching, she is showing her affection towards the poet. The poet is feeling very close to her by seeing in her eyes in the photograph. From the yellowing photograph, yellowing means from the discolored photograph, because the background of the photograph is now had turned to yellow color because of a long period. So from the yellowing photograph, misted over by time. Misted over means it has been covered with dust. It has been blurred looking. It has been dimmed looking because of the time. Long after a long time, he is seeing this photograph. It is a frank and serious look. Frank meaning straightforward look. Who are very honest, who are very open, very direct in speech are called the frank. She has a frank and serious look. And her eyes are stern. Her eyes are stern, meaning serious, unrelenting. That means they are very disciplined. The eyes are looking, were looking very serious. But they can laugh too. That means they can be soft too. Next paragraph. Her hair is pulled back tightly in a bun, and on her black dress she wears no jewelry. I never knew her, yet I recognize myself in her. So, three generations later. That means, let me explain. Her hair is pulled back. Children, you must have observed that our parents or grandparents, they used to have a hairstyle in which they will bring all the hairs, they will brought all the hairs together into a round shape. At the back of her head, at the back of the head, they will put a round shape. That is called the bun. So, she wears no jewelry, and she used to wear a very simple, without any jewelry. She used to have a black color dress. Here, dress means sari. I never knew her. That means, here the poet was born after his death. So, he never knew her, but still, I recognize myself in her. That means, still the poet finds or identifies himself in her. Three generations later, may my great-grandchildren feel as close to me as I now to her. As I now do to her. That means here the poet Alan Malay is expressing that three generations later. That means the poet is the first generation. Three generations burned after him. That is, the poet's children would be second generation. Their poet's grandchildren would be the third generation. So the poet is hoping, the poet is expecting that his third generation, his great grandchildren would remember him as close as he is now finding by seeing this photograph. That means he is also expecting that his great-grandchildren should miss him, should respect him, should show their love, affection, like he is getting from his great-grandmother. So this is the gist or summary. This is the explanation. Let's start with the glossary words and comprehension. Glossary words, that is hard words and meanings. Yellowing, meaning discolored or getting old. Misted, meaning covered or dimmed. Stern, meaning strict. Frank, meaning straightforward. Recognize, meaning understand or identify. Next, I'll give you some new words also. Great grandmother, meaning the mother of one's grandparent. Next, bun, meaning hairstyle. The hairs are brought together to a round shape, that is called bun. So these are the glossary words. Now, comprehension. First question. Answer the following questions in two or three sentences each. What has happened to the photograph and why? Answer is, the photograph is yellowing and misted over by time. Question number two. What expression does the poet read in the eyes of his great-grandmother? Her eyes are stern, but they can laugh too. Question number three. Describe the poet's great-grandmother as she appears in the photograph. Answer. Her looks are frank and serious. Her eyes are stern. Her hair is pulled back tightly in a bun. She wears no jewelry and she wears a black sari. Question number four. Did the poet know her personally? Why? Which line suggests this? Answer. No, the poet did not know her personally because he was born after her death. I never knew her, yet I recognized myself her three generations later. These lines tell that the poet did not know her personally. Question number five. She looks out at me. What does this opening line of the poem means? Answer is, the poet feels that his grandmother is looking out at him. That is, she is seeking him. She is searching him. She is finding close to him. Question number six. Pick out the word from the poem which means that the photograph is old. Answer is, yellowing, misted, on and by time. These words tell that the photograph is old. Question number seven. What were the feelings that the poet experienced when he looked at the photograph of his great-grandmother? Answer: the poet felt that may my great-grandchildren feel as close to me as I now do to her. Second, men, answer the following questions. Question number 1. Yet I recognize myself in her 3 generations later. Answer: question A. What does the word recognize mean in this context? The answer is, the word recognize means understand and identify himself with his great-grandmother. Question B. Explain the term 3 generations. Poet, first generation. Then the second generation is poet's children, and poet's great-grandchildren are called the third generation. Question number 2. What feelings or thoughts run in the poet's mind as he looks at the photograph of his great-grandmother? Answer is, the poet feels that his grandmother is looking out at him. He feels close to her, though he never knew her. He is able to recognize himself in her. He wishes that may his great-grandchildren feel as close to him as he then did to his own grandmother. Question number 3. What picture do you get about the great-grandmother of the poet? Answer is, we come to know that the grandmother had a frank and serious look. Her eyes are stern, but they could laugh too. Her hair is pulled back in a tight bun, and she is wearing a black sari and wears no jewelry. That's all, children. Hope you understand everything. Thank you.